So we are starting with the Niti Aayog. So what is this Niti Aayog? On August 2014, the government of India under Prime Minister Narendra Modi scrapped the Planning Commission, which was in existence. The Planning Commission has been scrapped on August 2014. And from Jan 2015, this Niti Aayog has been introduced in place of the Planning Commission. So what is Niti Aayog? What is the full form of this Niti? National Institute for Transforming India. So what type of body is this Niti Aayog? Whether it is a constitutional or non-constitutional, it is non-constitutional. Under non-constitutional, this is an executive body. Okay, which means that this Niti Aayog does not have any law backing. It is not based on any act passed. Okay, simply it is by an executive order passed by the government, passed by the Union Cabinet. That is Niti Aayog. So we all know that in place of this Planning Commission, this Niti Aayog has been replaced. Okay, so before studying about Niti Aayog, we should have an understanding about the Planning Commission also. Although this Planning Commission has been scrapped, in the point of view page, there is no questions being asked from Planning Commission, but we should have an understanding of the Planning Commission. Then only we can learn for the Niti Aayog. So now we'll study about the Planning Commission before entering of the Niti Aayog. So what is this Planning Commission? Same like Niti Aayog, this Planning Commission is also a non-constitutional body passed by an executive order. That is the Planning Commission. Okay. So what is the main function of this Planning Commission is to, as the name indicates, Planning Commission, to form a plan, to formulate a plan. Okay. To formulate a plan for the social and economic development of India. That is the main principle or agenda of this Planning Commission. So what is the other functions? Okay. First, it will formulate a plan. Next one, by the plan, it will analyze what are the problems, what are the hindrances for the economic development of India, and third one is the implementation of the plan. So it will formulate a plan, it will analyze what are the problems, and the third is the implementation. This is the main functions of this Planning Commission. So main thing, what is the composition of this Planning Commission? This Planning Commission is a multi-member body. First, this Planning Commission, PM is the chairman of this commission, and there is also a deputy chairman. This deputy chairman is this deputy chairman is the functional head of this commission. He is a functional head of the commission, and he is appointed by the Union Cabinet. He will be having a fixed tenure, and he is appointed by the Union Cabinet. And this commission also has some Union Cabinet ministers. Okay, it will have some Union Cabinet ministers, and also there are 4 to 7 full-time experts. Experts having practical knowledge with respect to planning. They will also be there, and there will be one member secretary. Usually this member secretary will be a senior IAS, picked up from a senior IAS. So this is the composition of the commission. So the main chairman is Prime Minister, and deputy chairman will be there. He is appointed by the Union Cabinet, and some Union Cabinet ministers will be there, and next 4 to 7 experts will be there, and member secretary will be there. This is the composition. So one thing we can clearly understand, there is no representation of states. There is no representation of state. That is the Planning Commission, and that's why it has been replaced with Niti Aayog, where you can find a representation of the state, which is the cooperative federalism. That is the main agenda of Niti Aayog, that will be dealing later. So now understand, there is no in this composition, you cannot find any representation from the states. So that is about the composition. We have already discussed about the functions. So is there any specialized wings in the Planning Commission? Yes, there is a specialized division within the Planning Commission. One is a technical committee, and next one is the planning advisory, and third one is the branch housekeeping committee. So this is the subdivisions inside the Planning Commission. So the main function of this Planning Commission is to formulate a plan. What plan? 5-year plan. Okay, this is very famous, and you can see in your books, there is 12 5-year plans has been there. And the 12th 5-year plan got ended in 2017. This Planning Commission has been scrapped before itself. 2014, it has been scrapped. So the last planning was the 12th 5-year plan, which ended in 2017. That is the main function of this Planning Commission. So another one thing here. Actually, this Planning Commission was established as an advisory body only. Okay, the advice given by the Planning Commission is not binding on the government. But day by day, what happened? This Planning Commission became a so serious thing, and the recommendations were taken by the government, and everybody was followed by that 5-year plan. Okay, this Planning Commission was initially it was an advisory body, but later on it became very serious, and that advice has been the recommendation has been taken by the government, both by the central and the state government. That's why the Planning Commission has become a very important thing afterwards. So that is about the Planning Commission. I hope you got an understanding about the Planning Commission. So this Planning Commission has been scrapped now. It is nowhere existence now. This Planning Commission has been replaced by the Niti Aayog. So now we will study about the Niti Aayog. Okay. So this is the order which I will be going. First, we have covered the Planning Commission. Basic idea I have given. So now we'll study about the composition of Nithya Ayog. Next about the specialized wings of Nithya Ayog. Third one is the functions of Nithya Ayog. And third one is the, there are some 7 principles and 7 pillars of Nithya Ayog. That is very important. And subordinate office of Nithya Ayog. And ADP, which is the current affair thing that I will explain later. And about the 5-year plan, what is the current status of this 5-year plan, and last about the National Development Council, that also has been scrapped, which I'll tell later. So this is the sequence which will be going, which I'll be covering in this video. First we'll start from the composition of Nithya Ayog. So as we all know, Nithya Ayog, National Institute for Transforming India, that is Nithya Ayog. So what is the objective of this Nithya Ayog? It is a policy think tank. Okay, it is a policy think tank for giving policy and directive inputs to the government of India. So what is this think tank? Wherever you refer Nithya Ayog, there will be a word like think tank. It is a think tank. So what is this think tank? Think tank is nothing but a group of members giving an advice. That is known as a think tank. So Nithya Ayog is a think tank giving policy and directive inputs to the government of India. Okay, so now we'll deal about the composition, which is very, very important. So first in the composition is the chairperson. So, who is the chairperson? Prime Minister. Next, we have something called the Governing Council. So, this Governing Council includes Chief Ministers of all the states, Chief Ministers of all the 28 states, and Chief Ministers of Union Territories with legislatures, and the Lieutenant Governors of the remaining Union Territories. These are formed as the Governing Council. Okay, this is the Governing Council, and here you can understand a clear difference between your Planning Commission and Nithya Ayog. When I am discussing about the composition of Planning Commission, I told there is no representation of states. Okay, that is the difference between planning, and that is the main agenda behind the formation of Nithya Ayog. Here you can find the representation of a states and also union territories. Okay, which means the main principle of cooperative federalism is being reflected in Nithya Ayog. That is the Governing Council, which includes CM of all the states, CM of Union Territories, and Lieutenant Governors. That is one thing. And third one is the Regional Councils. So if there is a particular problem with a particular region or particular state, or if there is a problem between two states, and then this Nithya Ayog will form a Regional Council with that state. So who will be involved in that Regional Council is the Chief Ministers of that particular region. Chief Ministers of particular states will be there. Okay. But one thing to be very... In the point of UPSC, one thing you should note here is these regional councils are convened by the Prime Minister. Okay, these regional councils are convened by the Prime Minister, but it will comprise of all the state chief ministers concerned. Okay, that is one point. Fourth one is the special invitees. So there is no maximum numbers for this special invitees. Government can nominate anyone. So who is nominating the special invitees? It is nominated by the Prime Minister again. Okay, special invitees who are having practical knowledge, who are experts in planning, they will be called here. Before in Planning Commission, I told it includes 4 to 7 experts. Same principle has been used here also, Nithya Ayog. Special invitees, it is nominated by the Prime Minister. Okay, nominated by Prime Minister. And fifth one, we have something called the full-time organizational framework. Okay, full-time organizational framework. Here, the first one is the vice chairperson. Earlier we have seen about the chairperson, which is the Prime Minister. Now comes the vice chairperson. He is being appointed by the Prime Minister. Vice chairperson is appointed by the Prime Minister, and he enjoys the rank of the Union Cabinet Minister. Okay, what are the salary, allowances, conditions of a Union Cabinet Minister is wholly enjoyed by this vice chairperson of Nithya Ayog also. In this full-time organizational framework, we have something called the vice chairperson. Okay, this vice chairperson is appointed by the Prime Minister. Okay, here I have used two words, if you note down. This vice chairperson is appointed by the Prime Minister. But while mentioning about the special invitees, I told special invitees is being nominated by the Prime Minister. So here you should understand the difference between the nomination and appointment. What is the exact difference between nomination and appointment? Okay, we can take a classroom. In a classroom, some 40 students are there. And I am also one among the students, okay. I have taken the first rank in the class, and that is a class teacher also, okay. So class teacher is asking me, Bharat, you just nominate someone as a class leader for this month. So I can nominate myself as a class leader, or I can say refer any of my friend as the class leader. I am choosing myself, or I am choosing my friend as a class leader. That is nomination, okay. So nomination means it is a choice, it is choosing. But when the class teacher itself pick up someone as a class leader, then it is a right. That is the appointment. That is the exact difference between appointment and nomination. Appointment is a right, okay, exercising their right. When class teacher is exercising her right to pick up someone as a class leader, it is the appointment. When I am choosing someone, it is known as the nomination. So nomination is appointment, and nomination is choice, and appointment is the right. That is the difference. Okay. So vice chairperson is being appointed by the prime minister, and he enjoys the rank of the union cabinet minister. Next, we have something called the members. Okay, members are of two types. One is full time, and another one is the part time members. With regard to full time members of Niti Aayog, we don't have any maximum limit. Okay. But about their rank, they enjoy the rank of a minister of state. Vice chairperson enjoys the rank of a cabinet minister, and the member, full-time member, enjoys the rank of a minister of a state. And when coming to the part-time members, we have a maximum limit, which is the 4. Okay, part-time we have a maximum limit 4. Where are these part-time members being picked up from? They are picked up from the well-recognized universities, from the colleges, and big experts. They are being picked up for this part-time members. And finally, we have something called, I'll write here, ex officio members. This ex officio members comes under this organizational framework only. I'm writing here, ex officio member. Four union cabinet ministers. Okay, four cabinet ministers. Another one we have, chief executive officer, CEO. He is appointed by the prime minister for a fixed tenure. Okay, CEO of Niti Aayog is being appointed by the prime minister for a fixed tenure. He enjoys the rank of secretary of government of India. Okay, that is about CEO. And what do you mean by ex officio member? Okay, when I'm dealing about many other non-constitutional bodies, I will be referring this word, ex officio member. What is the exact meaning of ex officio member? Is nothing but if a person is a chairman of a commission, let us say National Human Rights Commission, he is the chairman of National Human Rights Commission, because of the post he holds, he defaultly become the chairman or member of any other commission. It is a default post. Okay, he is given a one post of chairman of National Human Rights Commission. Because of that post, because of the weightage of the post, he is getting another 2-3 posts. That is known as the ex officio members. So that is ex officio members, four cabinet ministers. And chief executive officer also comes under the organizational framework of Niti Aayog. CEO is appointed by the prime minister for a fixed tenure, and he enjoys the position of a secretary of government of India. That is the composition of Niti Aayog. This is very important, this composition. UPSC has asked many questions from this composition. So once again, I am saying, chairperson, prime minister, governing council consists of all the CMs of states and union territories, and regional councils convened by prime minister, comprised of the chief ministers involved, and special invitees nominated by the prime minister. And we have full organizational framework. Under that, we have four things. One is vice chairperson, appointed by prime minister, enjoys the rank of a union cabinet minister. And members, we have two types, full time and part time. Full time, there is no maximum limit. They enjoy, the full time member of Niti Aayog enjoys the position of a minister of state. That is one thing. And part time members, there is a maximum limit. Four members only can be there. And another one is the ex officio members, four cabinet ministers. And chief executive officer enjoys the rank of secretary, appointed by prime minister for a fixed tenure. This is the composition. We have finished. Next, we are going to the specialized wings of Niti Aayog. So now about the specialized wings of Niti Aayog. We have three specialized wings of Niti Aayog. One is the research wing, consultancy wing, and Team India wing. Okay. So as the name suggests, research wing. This research wing will consist of top-notch experts. Okay. With top-notch experts, they will just research about the problems. They will formulate a plan. That is the research wing. And consultancy wing, okay, the plans formed by the research wing will go to the consultancy wing, and what they will do is they will process that plans, and if there is any hindrance, they will come with a solution. So this consultancy wing is generally a solution provider. Okay, so research wing they will research with the experts, top notch experts, they will research the problems, and they will give a recommendation to the consultancy wing, and this consultancy wing will analyze any hindrance factor to those recommendations, and it will come with a solution. So solution provider. So this Team India wing will comprise of this Team India wing. The composition of this Team India wing consists of representatives from all the states and union territories, and also from all the ministries. One person will be there. Okay. So this forms concerned. The Team India wing, what are the plans formed by Niti Aayog? It needs a concern from this Team India wing. This Team India wing consists of representatives from all the states and union territories, again praising the principle of cooperative federalism here. What is this cooperative federalism? That we'll deal later. So this is the research specialized wings of the Niti Aayog. So now about the functions of Niti Aayog. Okay, generally we know what is the function. They are planning a, they are formulating a plan. That is the function. General functions we know. But formally, what is the function of Niti Aayog? That I will just discuss now. The first function is to design policy and program framework, to form a framework. The second one is foster cooperative federalism. That's what I told. Okay, because in Team India wing, we had the representatives of every state, which is cooperative federalism. So that is the second function of Niti Aayog, foster cooperative federalism. Third one is monitoring evaluation, not only forming a plan, just to evaluate that also, monitor that evaluation, how the plan is going on, that monitor has also to be done by the Niti Aayog. And third one is the think tank knowledge and innovation hub, that is also another function of Niti Aayog. These four are the functions of Niti Aayog. Next, going to the principles and pillars. Okay, so we have some seven principles and seven pillars of Niti Aayog. Okay, I have a cheat code here for principles, which is nothing but GAS DIBBY. This is the cheat code for this principle, seven principles of Niti Aayog. Okay, G goes for governance and A goes for Antodaya. What do you mean by Antodaya? Nothing means the upliftment of the poor, upliftment of the minority people, upliftment of the poor. That is Antodaya. And governance, nothing but the transparency. That is governance. G for governance, A for Antodaya, and S for the sustainability. If they are coming with a plan, that plan should be a sustainable one. Okay, that they should keep in mind while researching that plan. That is a sustainability factor. So GAS, so again D goes for the demographic dividend. So what comes under demographic dividend is nothing but the focus on people's development, focus on the people's skill, education, for their health. That is the demographic dividend. That is for D. And I goes for inclusion. Make sure that everybody is included. Every citizen and every factors of India is being included in that program or plan with what we are formulating. That is inclusion. Third one and the sixth one is the participation. Make sure that everybody is being participant of the program or plan which you are formulating. That is participation. And last one is the village, which is our backbone of our economy, backbone of India. So that village should be the main focus. Village should not be left out in this plan. That is also another principle. So this is the seven principles of Niti Aayog. Starting from, this is a cheat code. GAS, DIBBY, G, governance, A, Antodaya. Antodaya means upliftment of poor. Okay, this word looks like a complex thing, but nothing but. Antodaya means upliftment of poor or the backward class. Antodaya. And S for sustainability. And D for demographic dividend. And inclusion, I. P for participation. And V for village. This is the seven principles. And next, we'll deal about the seven pillars of Niti Aayog. We have discussed about the principles of Niti Aayog. Now about the seven pillars of Niti Aayog. Okay. So the first pillar is the proactive, pro people, participative, which is PPP. That way you can remember. And empowering, inclusion, equality, and the last one is the transparency. So these are the seven pillars of Niti Aayog, and these pillars are self-explanatory. Proactive, pro people, participative, empowering, inclusion, equality, and transparency. So PPP, EIEP, EIET. That way you can remember the seven pillars. Okay. So that is about the pillars of principles and pillars. We have finished. So now next about the subordinate office. What is the subordinate office? Subordinate office of Niti Aayog. What do you mean by subordinate office? An office which comes under the control of the organization. Organization means Niti Aayog. Okay. So what is subordinate office? National Institute Labor, Economic and Research and Development. That is the institute coming under the direct control of Niti Aayog, subordinate office. Okay. So this NILERD, National Institute Labor, Economic, Research and Development, how it functions is with the grants in aid of Niti Aayog. Okay. The grants in aid of Niti Aayog will be the financial help for this institute, and also from the projects which they are giving contract. Okay, this NILRD will give the projects as a contract. Okay, so from that also the financially it will help the NILRD. So subordinate of Niti Aayog office is the NILERD. So that is a subordinate office. This ADP, which is the Aspirational District Program, it has been formulated in 2018. This is the current affairs which I am including here. This Aspirational District Program is one of the important milestone of this Niti Aayog, launched in 2018. So what is the main agenda of this ADP is to identify the main states. State is the main drivers of this program, to identify the states and what is their power, what are their plus points like that, what is the powers of a state, and in what way a certain state is lagging, okay, in what are the districts of the state which is lagging in some factors. In that way they'll identify the states, and they have identified also, okay, out of 28 states they have identified 115 districts. Okay, these districts they have identified as the aspirational district in the aspirational district program. They identified this 115 districts as aspirational districts. Okay, so these 115 districts, they will be working on 5 thematic areas. Those areas in what they will be working is the health and nutrition, first thing. Next one is the education. Third one is the agriculture and water resource. And fourth one is the financial and inclusion. The last one is the skill development and basic infrastructure. In these 5 areas, they will be working in these 115 aspirational districts. This is the current affairs which I am including here in the Niti Aayog. Okay. So, we have finished ADP also. So, next about the 5-year plan. Okay. So, what is this 5-year plan? When I am talking about the planning commission, I told the main function of this planning commission is to formulate a 5-year plan. Okay. So, that will be a plan, and that plan will be followed for 5 years. So, we had 12 5-year plans. So, now what is the status of this 5-year plan? That we will see in this 5-year plan. So, now about the 5-year plan. Okay. So, this 5-year plan, we all know it has been formulated by the planning commission. Okay. It has been formulated by planning commission. So, when it is being formulated by planning commission, there is no representation of a states. So, this is a centralized plan. That one thing we should keep in mind. Okay. So, already told there have been 12 5-year plans. That last 12th 5-year plan got existed in 2017. That I have told already. So, what is the process in which this 5-year plan takes place? Okay. First, the planning commission will come up with the 5-year plan, and from the planning commission it will go to the union cabinet, and when it gets the assent of this union cabinet, it will go to a body called NDC, National Development Council, which we'll talk about this later. So when this body NDC gives this assent, then it will go to the parliament, both house of the parliament, it should get the assent of the parliament, and from the parliament then it goes to the official gazette. Okay. So, this is the path in which this 5-year plan will travel. Okay. So, now what happens is, when this 5-year plan is being replaced with the 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog. Okay. 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog. So, what is the difference between your 5-year plan and this 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog? The main difference is, this 3-year agenda will not go to the parliament at all. Okay, there is no requirement for this 3-year agenda to get the formal assent of the parliament. Okay, this Niti Aayog will just get the approval of the cabinet. That's it. That is the first role. And this 3-year agenda will not have any role to propose a program or propose a plan or propose a fund. Those functions are not given to this 3-year agenda. Earlier in the 5-year plan, we had this provisions. 5-year plan can propose a plan, it can propose a scheme, it can propose a fund and all, but that is not with your 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog. That is the exact difference between your 5-year plan. So, one thing you should keep in mind is, this 5-year plan of planning commission has been replaced with the 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog, and that is the difference what I am talking about. So, with that 5-year plan we have finished. So, now I will deal with this NDC. To your note, this NDC is also is in the steps of being scrapped, okay, but still we will know about this NDC. So, now about the NDC, National Development Council. It has been formulated in the year 1952, same like your Planning Commission and Niti Aayog. This NDC is also a non-constitutional body. Okay, it has been passed by an executive order of a government of India. So, it comes under the classification of executive body. Okay, or you can say non-statutory body. So, that is with NDC. Now, about the composition of NDC, Prime Minister. Of course, he is the chairman, head, whatever you can say. Prime Minister is the chairperson of this NDC, and it also consists of the union ministers, and it also consists of CM of all the states and union territories. Last one, it consists of members of planning commission. It also has a secretary. Secretary is no different. The planning commission secretary acts as secretary for NDC also. Okay. The planning commission secretary acts as the secretary of NDC also. This is the composition of NDC. So, now about the functions. What are the functions of NDC? The main or the very important function of NDC is to give assent for the 5-year plan which is being formed by the planning commission. Okay. The planning commission's 5-year plan will get an assent by the NDC only. Okay. So that is the first one, giving assent. Next one, monitoring. Third one is evaluation. Fourth one is implementation. They will not only give the assent and sit quietly, okay. They will just, they will monitor the plan also. They will give the evaluation and they will just implement. They will work in the way how this plan is being implemented. That is also a function of NDC, okay. So that is with Niti Aayog. We have started from the planning commission. I have discussed about the composition functions of planning commission. Since it is being scrapped, there is no use for UPSC, but still you have to know what is planning commission. Then only you can understand the Niti Aayog. This planning commission has been scrapped. It has been replaced with Niti Aayog, National Institute for Transforming India. I have talked about the composition of Niti Aayog, which is very, very important. Okay. If you ask me, of all these topics, this composition of Niti Aayog is very, very important. There are some six classifications of composition that I have talked about, and specialized wings I have talked, and functions of Niti Aayog, that is also important. And this seven principles and pillars, those things you don't need to mug up and all. UPSC is not going to ask any MCQs from that also. Why I have talked this about principles and pillars is, it will be useful in your mains. When you are writing some points about Niti Aayog, you can include these principles and pillars here and there, so that you can get some marks. That is the way I have included this principle and pillars. And subordinate office, what is subordinate office? NILERD, National Institute Labour Economic Research and Development. That is a subordinate office of Niti Aayog. All the financials of this NILERD comes from the grants and aid of Niti Aayog, and also from the projects which they are giving contract. That is NILERD subordinate office. I also talked about one important current affairs, which is the aspirational district program. I identified 115 districts out of the 28 states. That is one current affairs here. I also talked about the current status of 5-year plan, which is being replaced by the 3-year agenda of Niti Aayog, and I've discussed about the difference. How is this 3-year program of Niti Aayog different from the planning commission's 5-year plan? Last, I have discussed about the NDC, National Development Council. It is in the steps of being scrapped. Okay. So that is Niti Aayog. Thank you for watching this video. We will meet in the next non-constitutional body video.